Yes, let us view of this episode.
Two hours after the first shots were fired, Brule was under Imperial control.
Despite us shooting the fuck out of a bunch of people.
By Empire standards, the raid on Brule would mark Welkin Gunther's first taste of battle and begin his rise to a Galleon hero.
Keep fucking spoilers, jeepers!
Alicia.
I thought I would be ready for this. I knew war meant this might happen. It hurts. Seeing my town overrun like this, seeing all those people killed, it's just not right. How could all this happen? It isn't human, Welkin.
Oh, the Empire's clearly a bunch of bad guys because.
You look at those birds and see how wild and free they are. But they all have their own territories. If anything threatens their home, they'll risk their lives to defend it. People are animals too. We do what we have to, when we have to. Animals are in a constant struggle
to stay
alive.
If birds could use guns, they would.
I've also seen them help each other, almost like they were cooperating in order to survive.
Cooperating?
That's why
jolly
I'm so
cooperation.
Studying natural science. That coexistence. I want to know how it works. If we could figure that out, mankind could put it to use for our own survival. That's why I want to be a teacher, so that I can pass that knowledge on to the children. I mean, even if we can't completely eliminate war, at least we might learn to live together as one people.
You think so?
Sure.
Welks, look. Martha fell asleep, so that makes me the babysitter. See, Alicia?
Oh, he's adorable.
Just like you said. Even in war, new life happens all around us.
Come now here. We have a baby.
Look, that's your hometown.
Maybe a little bit more on fire than usual, but, you know.
We'll come back home again.
Yes. Someday soon. I know it.
Chapter 3. Vassal Urban Warfare.
It's urban warfare time, boys! What you got for me?
In March of 1935, the Empire began its invasion across Gallia's eastern border.
Do I have to hit something?
Maximilian, no. Okay. Commander of the Gallian invasion front, built his army around mobile armor. Ghirlandio and the other fortresses along the border fell to his tanks in quick succession.
Blitzkrieg! In other words.
Brule's fall in under 2 hours was typical of villages in the Empire's path, and the road to the capital bore a steady flow of refugees.
We're all fucked.
Randgris, Gallia's capital, a town secure and stable since ancient times. Within its walls stood the castle Randgris, and within its unicorn spire resided Cordelia, Gallia's princess.
All right.
Supporting Gallia's policy of neutrality was a system of universal conscription.
I would imagine that's why they had tank school.
All schools required military training each year.
Yep, there you go.
In the event of a war, citizens were then drafted into the militia to defend their country.
Militia!
As the conflict with the East grew worse, both Welkin and Alicia found themselves no exceptions to that fate.
Plus, we have a tank. We've come equipped with a tank, so, you know.
So these are my new digs.
What?
Oh, my uniform. I should get changed before reporting in. Better get ready now.
Maybe I should put my stuff on before I report to the army this morning.
Flares, binoculars, a compass, and a map.
You're ready to be an NCO, boy.
Everything you need for a nice hike. Or combat.
Combat hike.
Welkin? Can I come in?
Sure, it's open.
I was just changing, I just left it open, you know. In case.
Oh, you're already changed too. Let's see. Not bad, not bad. You look good, actually.
Thanks.
So, how about me? Do I look all right in this? Convincing?
So we're trying to convince of what?
Let's take a look. Yeah, you look fine. You wear it like a pro.
Really? You're not just saying that?
Your uniform looks like shit.
Of course not. You look tough. I like it.
Oh, good. I was worried it looked kind of silly.
It's a uniform. Of course it looks silly.
No way. That plating on the back? It's like a coleopterid exoskeleton. Beetle-tastic.
Oh, Jesus.
Coleo what? And did you just say beetle? Welkin? What kind of girl wants to hear that she looks like a bug?
Huh? Not just any bug. A rhinoceros beetle, king of the insects. Who wouldn't want that?
Welkin, you're kind of an odd person, aren't you?
Uh-huh. I guess I'll just try to take that as a very Welkin sort of compliment.
Probably for the best.
Tell me about that scarf. You've been wearing it since I met you.
Oh, this? It's part of my uniform from the bakery.
Is that right?
I don't want to forget the time I spent busting my buns baking. I plan to keep wearing it until I can get back to manning the ovens again.
That's great. Once you do, I'll be first in line to get some of that bread.
Is that a promise? Well, I'll be sure to have plenty of it ready and waiting for you.
Small town peoples.
Absolutely. Hey, if you're ready,
we get home, we're gonna make some bread. Yes, let's go visit the captain. Hey, captain. We're new recruits. We'd just like to come for a visit. We do bring our own tank, though, so I guess maybe that's reason enough to go see the captain. Would you like an extra tank?
Come in.
Excuse me, ma'am.
And fellows.
Galleon Militia enlistee Welkin Gunther, reporting for duty.
Ma'am, Galleon Militia enlistee Alicia Melchiot, also reporting for duty.
I'm Captain Eleanor Varrott, commander of this regiment. Gunther, you're promoted to lieutenant. You'll be leader of Squad 7 now.
Ma'am!
Enlistee Melchiot, you're promoted to sergeant. You'll be under the lieutenant's command. Understood?
Ma'am!
You have schooling. You're a lieutenant.
It is you.
You're a baker. You're a sergeant.
Huh, Welkin? Valdio?
What the fuck name is that?
Yep. Now that there's a real war going on, I joined up.
Well, hang on. Didn't they just say that nobody had a choice?
You're just like you.
You know each other.
Yes, ma'am. We knew each other at university. Welkin was in science and I was in archaeology. And just look at us now.
No archaeology or science. Looks like the two of us are studying war, I guess.
Looks that way. It's good to see you.
And you.
That'll be all for now. There's a strategy briefing later today. But
time right?
For you to catch up. You'll be spending a lot of time on the post and in Randbreeze. They'll be your new home. So get to know them. That'll be all. Report back in time for the briefing. Until then, you're dismissed.
I'm not going to tell you when the briefing is, but I would like you to report back in time. Oh, sweet. We get some like ways to spend my money and experience points, I would imagine. Fight in combat, combat ability, new weaponry. Okay. All right. Well, let's start the squad barracks, I guess, and go down the list. Okay, so he's a tank commander. The scout. Shock trooper. And a lancer. Okay. Now apparently we have some kind of like a system here that's people probably talk to each other and shit. Kind of a la Fire Emblem-esque. Zero defense on anyone. Alright, that's good to know. And people have bad aim. Country bread and what are these things? Desert allergy, strong willed, big sister, child of nature, big hearted, loyal teammate. Okay, I have no idea what these bonuses are. Can I look at them? Q goes that way. E goes the other way. Yeah, I don't... Can't, like, mouse over them or anything. I don't know what these bonuses are. What they, how they work. It's unfortunate. Yes. You'll have to go look at the wiki or something. Alright, let's check out the command room.
It's good to see you doing the rounds. Welcome.
Hello, Captain.
This is the command room. Use it to structure your squad. You will have access to both drafted and volunteer recruits.
Alright.
Now that I think of it, Squad 7 is still short on soldiers, isn't it? I'll explain how this works.
Yes, thank you. I appreciate that.
This is the master list. The recruits have all been assigned classes based on their talents.
Like, sergeant, if you're a bread maker. Walking in your streets? Who? Oh, gotcha. Yeah, I just went and checked Facebook, so now, yes, I know. I'm not very far at all right now. I'm just getting to the portion where you can actually, like, structure your units and stuff like that. So, past the prologue, I guess.
I should probably touch on the five classes, just so we're clear.
Yes, you probably should touch on the five classes.
First off, you have the scouts. Just like the name suggests, they'll be your eyes. Their best asset is their mobility.
No, I'm not dead, Jarvis.
They can go out, collect intel, then make it back safely. That, and a keen eye for enemies. A good scout can spot a man in tall grass from 100 yards.
That's good to know.
That comes at the price of firepower. Their job is spotting enemies, not taking them out.
Holy shit, we might actually use scouts correctly.
Next up, the shock trooper. They're the ones to break through enemy lines and clean up.
Sounds good.
They offer excellent offense and defense. As far as combat goes, they're as good as it gets.
So shoot tons of things.
While they lack any specialized techniques, they also don't have any obvious shortcomings.
I was at annual training, so I was gone for a couple weeks, and then I've been trying to get my sleep schedule sorted out a little bit, so after I came back, I still wasn't on for a couple days.
Think of them as the least finicky unit in your squad, Lieutenant. After them, we have Lancers, then anti-tank units. They're critical when facing armored targets. Their purpose is pretty self-explanatory. In most cases,
yeah, right.
They're the only way to
sleeping.
Stop a tank.
Only results in brain damage. No. I mean, I would feel two ways about a surprise deployment, but no, I didn't. So.
They're also well shielded from explosives, which conveniently includes tank mortars.
So you can just you could run them up and not get them instantly killed. That's useful.
Sadly, they're slow and weak to gunfire. Their limited ammo could also be called a drawback.
Having limited ammo that's definitely a drawback. Yeah, it would be really shitty just to be like, oh no, you're gone. There's a lot of training they have to do before they mobilize guard units, so. Throw them at tank. Go! Go get the tanks!
Changing gears, we have the engineers. They handle supplies and perform combat support. They can restock other units' ammunitions, treat the wounded, even repair tanks on site.
So they're all-purpose medic-y style unit then. Do they have explosives?
They can place sandbags for cover, disarm mines, repair towers, you name it.
Wow, actually sounds really fucking useful.
Their actual combat skills are very low. Think of them as combat facilitators.
We are here to facilitate combat. You guys want to fight? We'll help you out. What's this? This is Valkyria Chronicles. It's a kind of a tactics game, I guess you would explain it as. You have a battle and you move units around it using turn-based combat. You'll have to actually see a fight to understand what's going on. I just got to like the screen where you actually like freaking get units and stuff like that. So it'll probably be a minute before I get into another fight.
Lastly, we have the snipers.
Sniper!
They can shoot down targets from a considerable distance.
What?
You won't find better soldiers for marksmanship and range. They can hit targets I can barely see. Sniping rifles also come with scopes that work to augment a sniper's natural eyesight. Drawbacks include low mobility and defense. If the enemy gets them alone, they're done for.
So snipers are all like asthmatics or something? I got this rifle in this range because... Oh, holy shit, I'm tired!
That should cover the basics.
She's like a school teacher or something, seriously.
Go ahead and put a squad together now.
Do it now!
Room for 20, and you can swap units at any time.
I wonder how many you can actually bring to combat, or I wonder if it varies. Do you know, Tawny? Do you know? whole bunch of scouts. Okay, there's some shock troopers. Pessimist. It's a pessimistic shock trooper. Jeebus, this is quite the list. I wish I knew what these... It's always 20. Okay. But when you go into a fight, does it, like... Okay. So, like, you could trade... Can you trade people out when, like, people go down and shit like that? Or you just, like, cycle them? Metal allergy? What? Interesting. Frail body. Man hater. Okay. And then. Gotcha. Okay. Pollen allergy. Night vision. Okay, now we're back around. So there's... It's a sniper, it's a sniper killer. Darson, hater, desert bred. On RNG, night vision, lone wolf. What is... Oh, there we go! Fantastic. That's an unfortunate thing for a sniper to have. Standing near... Fancies women! Yeah, there are a few people with fancies women. What is it? I'll have to find out what that actually does. Fire with enhanced accuracy. Oh, okay. Standing on sand sharpens my awareness. Okay. Well, fancy, I mean, fancies women means that they like women, as in, I would imagine, like, hates men, that would, well, feminists don't hate men either, though, so, they're only crazy fuckers that... So, I guess, like, Tumblr feminists... Increase in defense. So these two sniper choices I have are not fantastic. I mean, I guess this guy's alright. What is City Kid? Okay, paved roads. Less defense. Gotcha. Right. Lot of fights. Gotcha. Okay, so fancies women means the more women you have around, the better they shoot. So that. So in other words, if you could build like a. Wow. So she's actually... Oh, let's see, hang on. But probably... So being around men lowers her accuracy, though. That's one. So I'm sure having a female character with fancies women is a really good trait, because obviously then you can have more women around. but then Man-Hater is kind of... Yeah. Okay. Interesting. Frail body, eh? Okay. Desert bread. Okay. All my engineers suck. Or choices for engineers. Scout hater, just... I'll roll it against. Freak. There's a lot of negative traits in this game. Jeebus. Born leader. Wow. That is a really bad trait. Having less than full health makes your defense kit lower. Jeebus. Country bread. All right. So here. Defender. Is there anybody here that doesn't have... I mean, I'm sure everyone's got, like, their virtues and vices, but... Panicky, I don't think I've seen that one. That's a really shitty ability for a fucking shock trooper. Charging the enemy as a shock trooper causes me to panic. So how did we decide who should have what role again? Apparently all my shock troopers' nerves are shot. You look like you'd panic if you got close to the enemy. You're a shock trooper. Alright. Need freak. Ah, okay. So I'm assuming this means that if they lay on the ground that they have a... That they have a problem. But otherwise... Not a horrible character.
Hi, I'm Alex Raymond. I look forward to serving with you, Welkin.
Too excited. Go sit down. Actually, she has, like, all good abilities. Dredge, buddy. Yeah, bad back, eh? What? Pointed objects. Get you a dope-ass shock troop. Yeah, shock troops seem like they'd be pretty good. Obviously, they are just kind of an all-around good unit, so... Claustrophobic, eh? I'm assuming that, like, units cycle as you do missions as well, so I'm not, like, stuck with the same people the entire time. Frail Body, Desert Grid, Fatalist. All the engineers just have such horrible... Oh, man. Gotcha. That's good to know. Just shut in exactly. Okay. Well, of all the engineers, she's probably the best.
I'll do my best to live up to your expectations.
Thank you. Thank you for living. Let's hope you can do that. Despite the pollen allergy, she actually seems like she'd be alright. I don't know how many bushes and trees it takes to actually make her start losing HP. But night vision and lone wolf is not terrible. I mean, this guy's not bad either, honestly, Desert Bread. Yeah, I'll grab this guy.
My name is Cesare Regard, and I'll handle things my own way, thank you.
Oh, jeebus. Okay. Pessimist, mental energy, point meter, desert allergy, hater, top defender, scout hater, meat freak. I have one scout, so... Oh, she has no actual, like, downsides.
I'm Frieza York, handsome. I know you'll take real good care of me.
I'm not sure how to feel about that. Just go over there. Oh, I have 13 open slots. I don't know how many people you can actually take into combat normally. I'll try to get a couple of every role here. So I may not be able to do that with Engineer. Because all these abilities are so bad. Allergies technology, born leader. This guy, I mean, what's this? He can't see in the dark, he hates Darsons or whatever. But he's a child of nature. He likes hanging out in the trees. He just can't see anything. Ugh. City Kid, Camp Defender, and Lone Wolf. That's not too bad. Come on, Nils. Let's do it.
I'm Nils. Nils Dairdin. I'll see you on the field.
Holy shit. You have an amazing voice, sir. Yeah, he's actually in Germany now. He, got in, like, yesterday, I think. I think it was yesterday he actually got there. So he won't have internet for a while. But I'm sure he'll join us again once he does. Alright, I have two shock troopers, I have two lancers, I have two scouts currently. I don't have two snipers. Alright. Oh my gosh, I have to actually pick all 20. Holy shit. Alright, well. No homo. He'll be back in 2 years. I mean, obviously, he'll be playing with us online in, like, maybe a couple weeks, or a week, or something. I don't know how long it's going to take him to get set up in Germany. Okay, well, I guess you're coming along too, then.
Marina Wolfsten, at your command.
When will I finish, horsey calf? Mid our feet! Yeah, it's because, I mean, it's a deployment, but it's not really, it's not a war zone or anything, so. Thank you, Charvis. yeah, so he's going to be there for 2 years. This is just what his orders tell him to be there for a couple years. Yeah, if you end up going to his base or something, you might actually be able to freaking run into him. Yeah, if you go to a war zone, you're only there for like 6 months or a year, depending on what your job is. I think like the longest I've ever seen war zone deployments were like when we first started fighting in the Middle East. Well, recently. When they had like 2 year deployments for the army. Yeah, he's just PCS Germany, basically. Yeah, Kuwait is supposed to be fucking hot as shit. You mean like if you want to stay where you're at when you're going to ETS? I can extend. Like, usually you can extend out to a year or something like that. But you don't get anything for it. Oh, Jeebus. Desert bread, night vision, pessimist. Pessimist seems really bad. I guess This guy's alright, I guess.
My name's Hector Calvi, sir. I'm at your service from today on.
Alright, Hector Calvi. Lurking. Some pretty good scouts, so I'm gonna go back and look at them. What was this again? Oh yeah, that's right, afraid to point objects. You get hazard pay if you if you're in any war zone. It's usually hard to actually stay in war zones. I mean, unless it's like Korea or something. But they want to cycle you out. I mean, they used to have people stay there for a long time, but now they want to, because of psychological issues and stuff like that, it's actually like a war zone. But you could end up having to stay there longer. Like, they could just be like, oh, sorry, you gotta stay here longer. That can happen. Trooper hater? Is that like a scout? Oh, okay, shock troopers. We'll just have a whole bunch of people with pollen allergies.
Hey there, I'm Ika Thompson. I'll try my best. Sound good, Wilkin?
You don't sound very confident. Alright, what kind of people do... hang on. Alright, so three. I've only got the one engineer right now, a couple of snipers. Oh my gosh. Is this the guy that has like... Oh, my engineers are all so bad! This guy's not too bad. Actually, Fatalist is not too horrible because you have to be in the single digits to actually make it be a problem, so come on, boy.
Herbert Nielsen is me. I mean, I'll try.
This guy is amazing. Welcome to the team, Herbert. Jesus. Okay. Jeez, metalhead. And a fatalist. Actually, yeah, you can come along too.
I'm Ramsey Clement. Hey.
Hello. Alright, so 7 open slots still, cheapest. Okay. I need more shock troopers, I think. Oops. Alright, let's see, what do we got? What do we got for shock troopers? Answer killer, fancies women, desert allergy. Does that mean he's like... Man. What's an imp hater? Okay. Yeah, you're actually pretty good. Come on.
Payne Salinger, reporting for duty, sir.
Do you want to shave today, boy? pessimist, eh? Yeah, let's... Tell nature born leader? All these panicky people. So fuck his frail body again. Yeah, gotcha. You look good.
The name's Vice Engelbard. Let's go kick this war in the teeth.
It very well could be an Air Force recruiting center. Only you weren't panicky. Eddie. Alright, 5 more open slots. We'll probably use more Lancers. Was Neat Freak again? Oh, yeah. Yeah, oh, you people are so horrible. You know, she probably won't be laying down very often. Can't attack scouts very well. Alright. You'll do.
Hi, my name's Elise Moore. Nice to meet you.
Welcome to the party. Four more people. It's not too bad.
My name is Susie Evans, sir. I realize I'm inexperienced, but I'll do all I can.
It's not a good job interview. Hi, I know that I don't know what I'm doing, but I'll give it a shot. We're here to instill confidence, damn it. You know what? You're panicky, but fuck it.
I'm Edie Nelson. Perhaps you've heard of me. I'm sure we'll get along swimmingly.
Holy shit. Just go stand over there. Two more. Alright, how am I doing on units right now? It's 1, 2, 3, 4 scouts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 shock troops. 1, 2, 3, 4... Lancers, or that's all the snipers I can have, so. you just need to calm the fuck down. Oh, he's what's pessimist again? All right, Walter.
The name's Walter Nash, buddy. Pleasure to be working with you.
You're quite excited about this, aren't you? One more slot. All right. Who's got the best shit? Saudi, Trooper Killer, Kathy, Metal Bread, Sharp Things, Hunter Bread, Bat Back, Neat Freak, Chet Kathy, Child of Nature, Fancy's Men, Chet Kathy. Oh, Desert Allergy, Lancer Killer, Fancy's Women. I mean, this guy's alright, he's just got a desert allergy, which I'm not exactly sure how much sand there's gonna be yet. I mean, I suppose I was leaving behind in like, desert combat. Oh, that frail body. Prepared Lancer here, Camp Defender. Alright, you're my last person.
The name's Nina Streis, and I look forward to a good workout out there.
Alright. Most confident person I've frickin' recruited yet. Okay. So that should be everybody recruited then.
Well, feel like you've struck a balance?
Not really.
Come back anytime you'd like to adjust your squad.
Excuse me, I'd like to adjust
as
my squad.
As time passes, we'll have more recruits to choose from, so keep an eye on that list.
All right. And fire people that seem like they...
Oh, and all the recruits go through training together, so they're all ready for combat.
Some of them didn't seem like it. Not so much. And all of your choices for shock troopers were panicky. Who screens these people? Yes, Jarvis.
They'll be at the same level as the rest of the team you've taken into the field.
Okay, so when you recruit new people, they don't have to... Okay, eh, that's good.
You can swap out members without the worry of losing the benefit of their experience. Trust in your own judgment and pick a team you know you can work well with.
Okay, we're going to start trusting in my judgment. This is probably where things are going to go wrong.
That should be enough to get you started. You can figure out the rest as you go.
We're both officers. Why are we saluting
wow.
each other?
Squad leader's a lot of responsibility.
Squad leader. I need some help, squad leader.
Come to think of it, Faldio's heading up squad one, isn't he? I wonder if he's off sorting through this stuff now, too. I'd better get a move on.
He's in squad one, eh? That means he's probably gonna get killed. He's my friend. That means he's also gonna get killed. So I can feel a sense of loss and we know things are serious. Well, he's got the, like, anime looks, you know. Everybody kind of looks like they're 14. He might be 14. I don't know. I mean, he went to the university, so he's probably not 14, but... If you're non-commissioned, so if you're a junior enlisted or, like a non-commissioned officer or something like that, you salute all officers. And then they are supposed to salute you back. So it's merely, pretty much you just gotta know who's an officer and who's not. Obviously there are certain times when you don't salute. People, like, there are no salute zones and shit like that. Usually, you don't salute people when you're inside, usually. Shit like that. It's like if they walk by you outside, you salute them and give them the greeting of the day. Good afternoon, or whatever. But, yeah, officers don't salute each other. So, if you're an officer, then you don't gotta worry about it. I mean, you would salute in, like, certain circumstances. Like, you're changing... If you're, like, changing who's in command of a formation or something like that. But... If you're going Navy, though, you're going to have some of the Navy non-commissioned officers have shit that makes them look like officers, but I'm sure you'll learn about that, so... Okay, so unit training, eh? Let's go check that shit out.
Welcome to your worst nightmare. I'm the guy who's gonna whip you lazy blobs into shape.
You can tell that I'm serious because I've lost an eye. Whipping you lazy blobs into shape.
Still, I can't work miracles here. No amount of drilling beats real combat experience. I want you all to go out there, kick some imp tail, and then show me what you learned.
Come back here and show it to me. Well, I shot this guy in the face and I stabbed him to death. Where's Hale?
I will train that experience into something you can actually use. Level you bums up.
Subtle.
But!
Ah!
Don't go trying to hog all the glory. A squad's a team and we got no need for stars.
Yes.
You will train as a class and level up by class. Scout level 2. Scout level 3. You get it?
You're level 2 now.
Oh, but I don't want to be level 2.
You are.
Oh, okay.
When the scouts level up, that means each and every one of them goes up that level.
Oh, that's useful.
You hear me, maggots?
Jeebus, would you
and
stop
you
jumping from the side of the screen?
The rest of the team, go home now.
All right, goodbye.
All right. Now I'll show you lowlives how this whole thing actually works. It ain't complicated. First you go out there and fight, then divvy up that experience here.
Some experience for you, some for you, some for you.
Once the experience you cram into a soldier class clears a set amount, it'll level up.
All right.
Picking which class to level up and when.
You do it so often, it's losing all effect.
Squad leader. Now give it a go.
All right. So I have EXPs.
Train all you want. I've got all day.
All right. So tune. Wow, I've got a lot of experience points. So A and D. Oh, okay, just brings me to that. Oops. Just level everything up to level 2 right away, I guess. Yes. Yes, I am sure.
I got no use for tears! Sweat! Sweat! Sweat!
Level up.
Good work, maggots. You're one level closer to human.
Nice.
Looks like that session beat a new potential out of the Lancers. Looks like that session beat a new potential out of the Snipers.
Okay, so level 2 takes a lot more experience, or level 3 takes a lot more experience. Holy shit. Now, is EXP used for anything else, or just this? Because I don't want to spend all my EXP if it's something I need to spend on something else. Engineers are... Bringing up engineers to the next level is pretty cheap, actually, so I'm going to do that right away. I'll pour the rest of my XP into...
I got no you.
Gotcha.
Good work, maggots! You're one level close. Okay, you've earned clearance for a new order. Put it to good use out there.
Cool. Alright. That works.
Got it? That's how training by class works. Now get out there and rack up some experience.
By shooting dudes in their face.
Oh, and there's one more thing to add. Sometimes leveling up a unit class will unlock a hidden potential in them.
Right.
You can think of potentials as the natural abilities your soldiers have inside them.
Hence the name potential. Yeah, anyways.
Those abilities will form a big part of your strength in the field. So keep them in mind.
I think they'll be up to her, not me. In 10 years? I don't know. Yes. You guys can figure that out in 10 years.
Other times, leveling up a class will earn you clearance for a new order. Here, as long as we're talking about it, I'll teach you a classic. A real golden oldie.
Alright. Okay.
Orders are special commands you can give out as the squad leader.
Squad leader, squad leader.
It doesn't take a genius to see that leveling up your soldiers is the best way to beef up your squad. The soldiers will get stronger, and you just might unlock new potentials and orders. All that just from me working you sorry bums into the dirt.
Yep, sure, yep.
I just hope you maggots are ready for a real workout the next time I see you here.
Workout! Alright, so the R&D facility. I'm assuming this is where I spend the money that I've earned.
Welcome to R&D, man. What can I do you for?
I thought for sure you were a woman. Never mind. You have very fantastic eyelashes, sir.
Wait, I know that insignia. You're Lieutenant Gunther, aren't you?
Yes.
I knew it! Man, I've
How
heard
could
you
see anything?
You. That evacuation at Brühl was just... wow!
Yes, I drove a tank.
Protecting a tiny life in the middle of all that slaughter? Man!
You're a very excitable person, I see.
Oh, Lieutenant, you're good people. You get all my respect and then some, bro.
You're good people.
What's going on, Leon? I could hear you from clear across the hangar.
My R&D department.
Oh, Casey, check it out! It's Lieutenant Gunther! He's the man, man!
Alright, apparently my R&D department consists of a surfer dude and some other nerdy fellow.
Sorry about him, Lieutenant. He's like this all the time, I'm afraid. But where are my manners? I'm Kreese Cherney. I'm training here as a mechanic.
If you didn't say your name, I would have no idea how to pronounce it.
Oh, and I'm Leon Schmidt. But just call me Leon, bro. I'm your boy.
Okay.
So, Lieutenant Gunther, what brings you down to R&D today?
I don't know. Stuff, tell me what you got.
We do work here on weapons development, making upgraded weapons and equipment. And that includes rifles and machine guns. We can even soup up your tank.
All right.
Of course, research expenses aren't cheap.
I would imagine not.
With rifles and other firearms, we'll mass produce new models as they're developed.
I would like this one to be semi-automatic. I would like this one to have 3 triggers.
You won't have to worry about making enough for your squad. We'll outfit them.
Cool.
For tanks, you can upgrade the baseline performance of the body itself, or develop optional parts that you can add on to tweak out its specs.
Alright.
Right. You can choose which optional parts you want in the tank equipment section. Come in anytime and make adjustments based on the needs of the operation at hand.
I don't know what the operation at hand is currently, but... Interesting. Okay. Alright, what do we got for weapons development here? Uniforms, eh? Okay, it gives a +1. That seems like... that's universal, right? Okay, that's uniforms, blast suits... excuse me. So, 500 bucks for defense up 1? Yes. Yes, please.
Here you go, bro!
Thank you. Alright, I'll get a blast suit. I'll just give...
All set for
plus
you,
ones here. Start with. Accuracy boost. Firepower. Firepower. Accuracy.
Sorry, bro.
Alright. So, can't research question marks, gotcha. Yeah, we'll upgrade. Might as well upgrade weapons.
All set.
It's only 500 for that as well. I'll have to check out the tank stuff here in a moment. Increase the accuracy on our rifles.
All set.
Actually, fuck it. We'll just upgrade everything to level 1. We got the money. Might as well. Alright. We got for body enhancements. Reinforced barrel. Adds reinforced armor. Yeah, this stuff is where the expense comes in. Extra range, eh? I've had regulars that have lasted a really long time back when I used to play StarCraft. But in recent history, yeah, probably. Spare treads.
All set for you.
Alright. Okay. That's how that works. Gotcha. Alright, so that's equipped. Interesting.
Done.
I'm assuming the exclamation point means that I can't, that it's too expensive. So. What's that? Oh, okay. And this is Trevor, just brings me to that. Yeah, okay, cool.
Well, sir, was that helpful?
Yeah, sure.
We're working here around the clock to make possible tomorrow what's out of reach today.
All right.
Come again a little later. We'll do our best to have something useful for you by then.
Yeah, you better come back soon, bro. I am all fired up to work on stuff for you.
You just need to calm down. All right. Okay. So that looks like all the nonsense is out of the way. I'm gonna use the latrine quick and get some coffee, so I will be right back. Nope, not that. Where is my text? Where is it? Okay, yeah. Boop. Roop. Roop. Yes. Okay, here we go. Be right back.